Amen.
I like you to say this four times to yourself. My time has come.
My time has come.
Number two.
My time has come.
Number three.
My time has come.
Number four.
My time has come.
We are in the days of revival. We are in the days of the move of the Spirit of God. And I'm believing God with you today that God is going to do some heavy, mighty, great manifestation of His grace in your life.
Amen.
For the endless expectation of the creature waited for the manifestation of the sons of God. The world is waiting for a manifestation, and the manifestation of the sons has been revealed. And I'm believing God, we are going to be a frontliner in this end time manifestation.
Amen.
Wonders Without Number is a ministering angel. We pray online, and people fall in love with God. And in the midst of falling in love with God, we see the move of God in our lives. So right now, this is how it works. As you are with us online today, I'd like you to be joyful. Forget about what you're going through. Forget about the challenges. Forget about the limitation. In Psalm 34, verse 1, he says, I will bless the Lord at all times, and his praise shall continually be in my mouth. All times, good times, bad times, low times, high moments, I will bless the Lord at all times, and his praise shall continually be in my mouth. So be excited. Doesn't matter what the challenges are. Be super excited. Be super excited. Because God is set out for your good. He set out to reach to you. He set out to do great and mighty things in your life.
Amen.
The Bible says in the book of James chapter 1 from verse 2, count it all joy when you fall into diverse temptation. Down to verse 3, 4, he says, for the trying of your faith, worketh patience. Let patience have a perfect work in you, that you will be entire, wanting nothing. That is verse 4, that you'll be entire, wanting nothing. So the reason why God allows many challenges and troubles of our life is to teach us patience. It's to teach us patience. Sometimes when we are moving with so much speed and we're moving with so much force, and God knows we're going to crash with the pace we are taking, He allows certain things to happen. He doesn't bring them, He allows them. He doesn't bring them, but He allows them. He didn't bring the affliction on Job. He allowed it. Why? To teach you patience. So, but you learn from it and you learn to take it easy. So God will allow that to happen in a while. So be joyful. Philippians 4 verse 4. He says, rejoice in the Lord always. And again, I say, rejoice. See, rejoice. Again, I say, rejoice. In Isaiah chapter 12 and verse 3. He said, with joy shall we draw water from the wells of salvation. In Psalm 16:11, he said, thou wilt show me the path of life, for in thy presence there's fullness of joy, at thy right hand are pleasures forevermore. So I'd like you to just be excited today at what God is doing. Right now, touch the like button. Everybody watching on YouTube, touch the like button. If you're watching on television, pick up your phone and make a call. Call someone and tell them, Wonders Without Number is on the air. It's time to pray. For if there's a man to pray,
there is a call to answer.
Begin to share the link furiously. Share it. Just share it. Share it. Share it. Dedicatedly share it. Let somebody be blessed. You know, when you do all of this, you are being a partaker of His promises and this assignment He has given to us. You know, I ministering and you touching the like button, you sharing, we are doing the same thing. God is going to give us the same reward because that's your platform. That's what you have access to doing. So you are doing it. 1 Samuel chapter 30, verse 24. I like the last part. As the part of he that goes forth to battle, so is the part of he that tarries by the stuff, they shall part alike. As the part of he that goes forth to battle, so is the part of he that tarries by the stuff, they shall part alike. 1 Samuel 30 and verse 24. As the part of he that goes forth to battle, the one that's spearheading the battle, and the one that stays back to take care of the sheep, to take care of, you know, the home front, the one who goes forth to battle, and the one that stays back to take up the home front, to make sure that those who go forth to battle come back and make the home front, you know, in order, he says both of them will get the same reward. As the part of he that goes forth to battle, so is the part of he that tarries by the stuff, they shall part alike. They shall have the same part and the same reward. So right now, touch that like button and we're about to go into the place of prayer. If there's a man to pray,
there is a call to answer.
God is more eager to attend to your needs, more eager to meet your needs. In Isaiah 65, verse 24, he said, before you call, I will answer. While you are yet speaking, I will hear. We call that Operation Cash in our church. Before you call, see, I will answer. A. While you are speaking, S. I will hear. H. C-A-S-H. Call, answer, speaking, hear. That's cash. So God is out to give you cash.
Amen.
He's out. As you call, he will answer. You're speaking, he will hear. So he's going to reach out to you. Luke chapter 12, verse 32. I love it. I love it. Fear not, little flocks. Fear not, little flocks, for it's your Father's goodwill, good pleasure to give you the kingdom. God is desirous. In Psalm 84, verse 11, for the Lord is a sun and a shade. The Lord will give grace and glory. No good thing will be withheld from them that walk uprightly. The Lord is a sun, illumination, and a shade, so that when your brightness is heavy, anyone who comes for attack out of envy because they see your illumination, God becomes a shield. It's not just your sun to give you brightness. It's a shield to protect you when you're going through all the negative, disadvantage, all the militating forces, forces that come against those who are illuminated. You see, it becomes your shield. And apart from that, it will give grace to sustain the illumination and glory. It will give grace and glory. Nothing good will be withheld from them that walk uprightly. We are about to do a warfare prayer today. We're about to do a warfare prayer today. I don't believe God for you. I'm believing God for you. I'm believing God for you.
Amen.
Thank you, Father.
Thank you, Jesus.
We bless your name.
Yes, Lord.
We thank you.
Thank you, Jesus.
We thank you. We thank you. That wonderful name, Jesus. That wonderful name, Jesus. That wonderful name, Jesus. There is no other name I know. That wonderful name, Jesus. That wonderful name, Jesus. That wonderful name, Jesus. There is no other name I know. That wonderful name, Jesus. That wonderful name, Jesus. That wonderful name, Jesus. There is no other name I know. That wonderful name, Jesus. That wonderful name, Jesus. That wonderful name, Jesus. There is no other name I know.
that wonderful name, Jesus. Oh, that wonderful name, Jesus. That wonderful name, Jesus. There is no other name I know. He is Lord, He is Lord, He is Lord. Amen. He has risen from the dead. He is Lord. Every knee shall bow, every tongue confess that Jesus Christ is the Lord. He is Lord. He is Lord. He is Lord. Amen. He has risen from the dead. He is Lord. Every knee must bow, every tongue confess that Jesus Christ is the Lord. He is Lord. He is Lord. He is Lord. Amen. He has risen from thy dead. He is Lord. Every knee must bow, every tongue confess that Jesus Christ is the Lord. Every knee shall bow, every tongue confess that Jesus Christ is the Lord. Every knee should bow, every tongue confess that Jesus Christ is the Lord. Messiah is the King of Kings. Messiah is the Lord of Lords. Messiah is the King of Kings. Messiah is the Lord of Lords. Hallelujah. 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 Who is wonderful is Jesus. Who is wonderful It's Jesus who is wonderful. It's Jesus who is marvelous. It's Jesus who is wonderful. It's Jesus who is marvelous. It's Jesus who is powerful. It's Jesus who is wonderful. It's Jesus who is the King of Kings. It's Jesus who is the Lord of Lords. It's Jesus who is the mighty God. It's Jesus who reigns supreme. It's Jesus. Shout hallelujah. Hallelujah. 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 In Jesus' name we worship.
Amen.
Matthew chapter 12 and verse 29. Matthew 12:29. Matthew 12. Or else, how can one enter into a strong man's house and spoil his goods? Except he first bind the strong man. That's what we want to do. Except he first bind the strong man and then he will spoil his house. Except he first bind the strong man, and then he will spoil his house. Now, most times, why we do not experience restoration and experience speed and progression is because we have not bound the strong man. If the strong man is in chains and bound, then it is easy to enjoy acceleration. There is a strong man. Anytime you are going through a stronghold, what is a stronghold? A stronghold is a challenge that the more you confront in the prayer, the more it appears to raise up and rear its ugly head. A stronghold is a challenge that seems to be fasting resistant. A stronghold is a challenge that seems to be sacrifice contending. A stronghold is a confrontation that seem to be in strong contest with prayer. And every stronghold is empowered by a strong man. Jesus acknowledged the reality of strong men. He acknowledged the existence of strong men. He acknowledged the oppressions of strong men. He acknowledged the manifestations of strong men. And he said, there is a way not just to handle the strong man, there's a way to take from the strong man that which he has taken from you. There are strong men in families. Their duty is to keep goods. From what we hear there, that's the duty of the strong man, to keep goods. They want to grab what belongs to others. They want to take it for themselves. That is what the Bible says, except you bind the strong man and spoil his house and spoil his goods. Originally, they are not his goods. They are not his talents. This is what he has taken from other family members and has converted it to his own. And sometimes a strong man will have to conscript others and to work hand in hand with him, to be in tandem with him. So, strong men, real do exist. Okay. But what the strong men have is powers, not power. The strong men operate with powers, not power. There is power above powers. They are classified as powers.
The Bible says in Colossians chapter 2, verse 15, having spoiled principalities and powers, he made an open show of them, triumphing over them in it. The Bible says in Ephesians 6, verse 12, we wrestle not against flesh and blood, but against principalities and powers. Powers. In Romans 13, verse 1, he said, let every power be subject to the let higher powers. For there is no power except that which be of God. Let every soul be subject to higher powers. For there is no power except that which be of God. The Bible makes it clear. God has given us power over all the powers of the enemy. I think in Luke 10, 19, that shall take up serpents and scorpions, and they shall by no means hurt you. I give unto you power over the powers of the enemy, and nothing shall by enemies hurt you. Behold, I give unto you power to tread on serpents and scorpions, and over all the power of the enemy, and nothing shall by enemies hurt you. So we must understand that we are in a contest and a clash of power. But how do you handle the strong man? That's my emphasis. The Bible says, bind him. Bind him. Afflict him. Deal with him. Keep him in chains. There are some strong men in your family line, in your village, in your municipality, in your hometown, that after now, when we pray today, God shall bind them.
Amen.
Some of them, it can be strange ailments. It can be any kind of attack. God shall bind them.
Amen.
There are some strong men that don't need to be killed immediately. They need to be bound. Keep them bound so that they can open their mouth and confess all they have done before they expire. Bind them. Matthew 16, 19. Matthew 18, 18. Whatsoever you bind on earth shall be bound in heaven. I say unto you, whatever you shall bind on earth shall be bound in heaven. Whatsoever you shall loose on earth shall be loosed. Same thing in Matthew 16, 19. Now, yes, the Bible didn't say whatever is bound in heaven will be bound on earth. It didn't say whatever is loosed in heaven will be loosed. No, it said whatever is bound on earth shall be bound in heaven. Loosed on earth, loosed in heaven. So it is earth that determines what heaven binds. It is we on earth that determines what heaven binds. If we don't bind it on earth, it cannot be bound in heaven. So God is waiting for you to see what you are going to bind. There was a man called Daniel. Daniel was a man who picked up the act of being addicted to prayer. Certain people came and brought a decree that nobody should pray. Can you imagine? The only way they could fault him was prayer. A man's prayer life was so profound, so pronounced, so announced, so known, that that was the only way they could fault him. And the Bible says, they could have no occasion against him except the law of his God. And in Daniel chapter 6, the Bible says in verse 10, when Daniel knew that the decree was signed, he opened his chamber. He went into his house and his windows being opened in his chamber toward Jerusalem. That was the seat of power. That was where they did what they did. And he prayed and gave thanks, as did aforetime. What does that tell you? Intimacy. As he did regularly. Nothing should affect your fellowship with God. When the Lord vindicated him, the Bible says the king brought him out, but the king did something. In verse 24, all those that conspired against Daniel, the king commanded them to be thrown. He bound them. Because if they are not bound, they will continue. There was a man called Haman. Haman planned against Mordecai, dug a gallows. The king, Daniel chapter 6, verse 1. Esther 6, verse 1, sorry. The Bible says at night the king could not sleep. The king commanded the book of the Chronicles to be brought to him. And that was when he remembered that somebody saved his life. And while he was contemplating, Haman was downstairs. And he asked him, what shall be done for the man who the king delights to honor? Haman felt he was the one and began to give accolades. Let the king do this for him. Let the king give me a royal apparel, put him on a horse. The king said, okay, go and do all of this for Mordecai. He put Mordecai on the horse, rode through the city. When I saw that, I was excited. I said, Kai, Mordecai is now free. But I was surprised in verse 12. The Bible says, Mordecai returned to the gate. Mordecai returned to the gate. Verse 12. Mordecai came again to the gate. How would you go through all the celebration? They put you on the horse. They put an apparel on you. Why coming back to the gate? Mordecai knew that so long a man was still breathing, still hale and happy, he will not give up. He will reinforce. And that's what some of us are going through. Sometimes when you pray, you fast, it's as though you are enjoying a respite. The bondage and the challenge come back in full force. You say, but I prayed, but I fasted. Yes, you did. What God actually heard you. What happened was that there was a reinforcement. So don't become discouraged and feel like, I'm tired. No! If the powers fighting you are so serious on your matter, that should let you know how important you are. If the powers contending you are so aggressive, are so serious, and will not let you be, the more you pray, the more they are contending you. You want to give up when they have not given up? You can't give up. They will give up.
Amen.
You are not the one to give up. Your problem will give up.
Amen.
You are not the one to give up. Your battles will give up.
Amen.
That's why Wonders Without Number is here. To tell you, don't give up. Keep pushing it. Keep pushing it. Every strong man in my life, in my family, I bind you.
Amen.
Every strong man in my life, in my family, I bind you.
Amen.
Every strong man in my life, in my family, I bind you.
Amen.
As you are saying, I bind you, God is sending arrows. He's sending missiles.
Amen.
Wherever they are,
amen.
God is sending missiles.
Amen.
Something will happen to that strong man that will strike him down.
Amen.
Many of them will go blind.
Amen.
Some of them will go paralyzed.
Amen.
God says you will bind them.
Amen.
That is how to enter a strong man's house. He said, bind him. Every strong man in my life, in my family, I bind you.
Amen.
I bind you.
Amen.
Somebody say, my father, my father.
My father.
Shout it loud and clear.
My father.
Let the enemies hear your voice.
My father.
Let the angels hear your voice.
My father.
In the name of Jesus.
In the name of Jesus.
As I begin to pray.
Every strong man.
In my family.
In my family.
I bind you. Every strong man. In my life.
In my family.
I bind you. Put your mouth and fire prayers right now.
Yeah,
Yeah, Ya da 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 Yeah,
Or else can one, how can one enter into a strong man's house? Well, it's good, except he bind the strong man and then spoil his goods. Enter into a strong, it takes the Holy Ghost to locate where the strong man's house is. And when you enter the strong man's house, it takes the Holy Ghost to locate where the goods are kept and spoil his goods. Any location in the spirit where my goods are kept, in the name of Jesus, I break into it and I collect them.
Amen.
Any location in the spirit where my goods are kept. Look at what the Bible first says. It says, first, enter and spoil. Enter and collect. So you must first enter, break in, then you locate where it's kept, you collect it. Any location in the spirit realm, any location in the realm of the spirit where my goods are kept, your goods, your marriage, your increase, your prosperity, the fruit of your prophecy, the fruit of your labor, any location where my goods are kept, I break in and I collect them.
Yes.
My Father, my Father,
my father.
In the name of Jesus,
in the name of Jesus,
I begin to pray.
Any
location,
any location
where my goods are kept,
where my goods are kept.
I break in, and I collect them.
Any location,
in the realm of the spirit,
any location,
in the realm of the spirit,
any location,
in the realm of the spirit,
Yada,
Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Father.
Connect your faith to my faith.
I connect.
Wherever you are, connect your faith to my faith.
I connect.
Connect your faith to my faith.
I connect.
Connect your faith to my faith.
I connect.
By the word of the Lord. By the word of the Lord. Or else, how can one enter into a strong man's house and spoil his goods, except he first bind the strong man? Bind the strong man. Bind the strong man. Bind the strong man. Bind the strong man. Right where you are. As you connect your faith to my faith,
I connect
every strong man in your family by the word of the Lord, standing upon this word,
I bind them.
Amen.
I bind them.
Amen.
Maternally, I bind them.
Amen.
Paternally, I bind them.
Amen.
Maritally, I bind them.
Amen.
Financially, I bind them.
Amen.
In the life of your children, I bind them.
Amen.
In your career, I bind them.
Amen.
Over your spiritual life, I bind them.
Amen.
Right where you are. Wherever they've kept your goods, we trace the location in the realm of the spirit.
Amen.
We break in.
Amen.
We retrieve the goods.
Amen.
We give them to you.
Amen.
Take back your goods.
Amen.
Take your marriage.
Amen.
Take your wedding.
Amen.
Take your finance.
Amen.
Take your health.
Amen.
Take your children.
Amen.
Take their destiny.
Amen.
Take their increase.
Amen.
Take their rising.
Amen.
Take your announcement.
Amen.
Take your honor.
Amen.
Take your dignity.
Amen.
There's a twin, set of twin watching. You are a twin. Your mother is dead. Your father married another woman that has been raising your people. But it's coming to a point now, this set of twin, that this woman that's like a stepmother wants both of you dead. She wants both of you dead. And she has even chased you out of the house, turned your father's face against you. You are suffering. But this is the response from the throne of God.
Amen.
God has arisen from for you.
Amen.
You shall meet a helper.
Amen.
That will stand by you.
Amen.
A destiny helper.
Amen. Amen.
And the Lord will judge her.
Amen.
I see a family where there has been different kind of challenge. Deformity, attacks, death, sudden sickness, insanity, all the activities of a strong man. Today, this power is broken.
Amen.
And everyone afflicted is free.
Amen.
Somebody by the name of Itwa. Itwa. I don't know who is around you that's a false person. It's a uniform person. Someone around you, Itwa. Somebody around you is a uniform person. You're expecting something very huge in the form of a contract. But from the day you started the deal to process it, you're afflicted. And now you're not even talking about the contract, you're talking about your health. Because someone was in competition over that contract. And now you're afflicted in your health. What the enemy put on you, the decree that is lifted from you and put on them.
Amen.
There's someone by the name of Marie. Besong. Marie. Besong. The Lord just whispered to my ears to tell you, Marie Besong, that good news is coming.
Amen.
Good news is coming.
Amen.
Wherever you are hearing my voice also, God said to tell you also, good news is coming.
Amen.
There's a pastor, Reverend Anthony. I'm seeing this very clearly. Reverend Anthony. That's your name. Reverend Anthony. It's as though you are anointed of God. You are genuine. You are intimate with the Holy Spirit. But it's as though all your effort is going down the drain in ministry. Recently, in your church, somebody slumped and died. That brought confusion to the whole place and brought shame on you. The Lord said to tell you that He loves you. He called you. That you should rise up and not be discouraged, because He's giving you a new phase in life and ministry.
Amen.
That what the enemy meant for evil, He has turned around for good.
Amen.
I decree.
I receive.
Be blessed.
Amen.
Be blessed.
Amen.
Be blessed.
Amen.
Rebecca. Lebby. Lebby. Concerning you, I'm hearing announcement.
Amen.
God say, we announce you.
Amen.
He will announce you.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Someone lost his ID card. I don't know what the ID card is for, but it's very important. You need it. Your ID card, and you've been looking for it everywhere. The Lord says you lift up. Go to your bed and lift up the mattress. I didn't say check the edge. I said lift it up.